Just recently, I unlocked all 294 characters on the Apple TV version of Crossy Road, which even includes the newly released Japanese characters. I suppose I shouldn't have been surprised by the announcement of Crossy Road Plus. Apparently, Hipster Whale wants to keep players playing. The new game seems to have more of an exploration theme, as there appears to be an overworld map. I'm looking forward to playing it, although I would have preferred Hipster Whale launch a new tower on Crossy Road Castle. Anyway, before starting on the new game, I figured now's the perfect time to launch this video. Out of nearly 300 characters, which ones are the best? What are the top 10 Crossy Road characters? That's the topic of this video. Starting the list at number 10 is Michael Boom. He's unlockable by ramming a character into the lower side of a missile truck. I consider this 10th spot the shooter category, as Michael Boom has special effects that affect the look of the environment. The shadows of jets whiz across the screen, while bombs explode around the character. While other characters, such as the Mad Wizard or the Dragon, can do damage to the environment too, there's a lot more destruction with Michael Boom. And when I first unlocked this character, I had a really good laugh. It shows Hipster Whale's sense of humor. This is clearly a spoof on Michael Bay. And the lens flare, that's a nice touch. The Dragon was a really close competitor in this category, as there's a trick to make the Dragon shoot lots of fire. If you just let the Dragon sit still at the beginning, it starts to spit more fire. That makes it easier to light up the trees and the cars. The reason Michael Boom is in the 10th spot, and not higher, is because the explosions don't do any real damage. You still have to hop around the charred remains. At number 9 is the Thesaurus. This dinosaur character wins the funny category. While I'm not a big fan of the dinosaur environment, this character makes it lots of fun. The joke is a play on words, but it's more than that. This dinosaur actually lives up to its name. While hopping around this prehistoric level, words will float into the screen. It's reading from a book of similar words. Really nice touch. This is similar to the Doge dog, and while I find the culture around Dogecoin to be amusing, I don't think this Crossy Road character is as funny as the Thesaurus. Perhaps it's the use of Comic Sans. You can't really blame Hipster Whale for that, though. That's the culture around that crypto coin. At number 8 is the Birthday Chicken. This is the winner of the Festive category. With blocky balloons, dancing trees, swaying buildings, fireworks, and lots of bouncing characters, this is a nice upgrade to the default chicken character. This seems like a nice way to liven up a birthday party. If you're hosting such a party, you could have a bunch of kids compete for the top score, and then you can give a prize to the winner. It doesn't have to be anything fancy, like a remote-controlled Cybertruck. Perhaps it's just something simple, like a cupcake. At number 7, the Easter Bunny marks another special occasion. It's the winner of the holiday category. However, this character is kinda tragic. This level has a big cute bunny with giant edible carrots. However, if you eat the little blocky objects on the ground, new bunnies will appear. They will follow you as you hop through the level. As you eat more blocks, more bunnies will appear. These trailing comrades are highly prone to death. They're really difficult to keep alive, as there's simply not enough space to do it. You could trip over them yourself, flattening them immediately. The worst part is the sad sound that they make when they die. Regardless, I really enjoy this level. It's funny and challenging. Too bad it doesn't keep track of the most bunnies kept alive at once. In the number 6 spot, this next character knows a lot about a new scoring method. It's the Pro Gamer. At the top left, underneath your score, are the letters APM. That's an acronym for Actions Per Minute. The more moves you make, the higher your score. It encourages you to make more risky maneuvers. That's not the only encouragement, though. The real highlight of this character is the announcer. A Korean voiceover adds drama to the action. as if you were playing for an audience in a gaming tournament. The words are not perfectly tied to the action, but it's close enough. It's in Korean, so I don't know exactly what he's saying anyway. I really tried to understand too, using a translation app, but it didn't quite work. If you like playing Crossy Road in a different way, the character ranked at number 5 wins the unique game mode category. It's Pac-Man. Wow, I was really impressed to see this iconic 1980s arcade character make an appearance here. Hipster Whale faithfully portrayed this historic game in a modern way. It's an excellent crossover. More importantly, it's fun to play. Scoring depends not on distance traveled, but by the number of pellets and ghosts eaten. What's especially great is the game over screen for advancing too slowly, which is an adaptation of the 256 level glitch. Very nice. At number 4 is the Moon Rock. This wins the Workhorse category. As you play Crossy Road, quests will appear, such as completing 300 hops. I used to dread seeing the Lily Pad quest, or even the Log quest, until I learned that the Moon Rock would make short work of it. These spaces may not look like lily pads, but the game counts it as a lily pad. The same holds true for logs. That's why I use the space rock for those quests. Also, it's not noisy like most of the other characters. It just quietly goes to work. I like the space environment too. It's a nice change of pace. Raising the shields to block asteroid attacks is fun too. But as an alternative, as you can't complete the bird quest in space, is the cyclist. This sporty character can silently zip through the obstacles. The character in the third spot was also chosen based on sound effects. It's the baby bunny. It's the winner of the cute category. Not only is this miniature character adorable, it doesn't sound like a dog's squeaky toy. Additionally, it's fun watching the baby bunny scare the birds. Look at it go. So brave. In second place is a surprising choice. It's the Toothbrush. This character is the winner of the overpowered category. It seems the creators at Hipster Whale might have been going a little crazy while working at home, as this level is quite different. It's as if they looked around their homes and whatever they saw, they put it in the game. As an example, one of the main attractions of this level is hiding behind a toilet, in order to avoid an attacking wave of cleaning products. Is this a deeper critique of life in modern times? Anyway, this level is great for scoring. That's because of the shape of the toothbrush. It's so tiny. Oh sure, there's the flea, but that's hard to see, especially by the way it moves. The toothbrush thicks up, but vertical spacing doesn't matter. It's the ground coverage that matters. That's just a few squares. This means that the toothbrush can weave through spaces that other characters can't. Also, you don't have to wait for logs. If you hate logs, At Home is a great level. Not counting the daily challenges, I got my best score with the toothbrush. That brings us up to number 1. Well, you can subtract 1 from every other character on this list, because that's my top 9. What's in the top 10? Well, that's up to you. What do you think is the 10th best character? Or do you have a different character that you think should be at number 1? You can let the world know in the comments.